Yes, it's on, it's already on.
So I'll leave it, it's on.
Okay.
No more charges. Okay. Live now, huh?
Mm-hmm, yeah. I just got to fix it where.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو
قائدنا ومرشدنا وحجتنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وطاعته، وأحثكم على التمسك بهدي قرآنه وسنة نبيه. فقد قال الله جل من قائل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. My dear brothers, sisters, I used to read in the books of hadith what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied about a day coming upon this ummah when Hajj and Umrah will be suspended, and I could not limited imagination feel how could that be. The place that is filled with millions of people, day and night, no interruption except for Salat al-Jama'ah, when all those in the vicinity of the Kaaba will be praying together. Other than that, Tawaf was around the clock, as they say. Hajj every year, millions of people. This is what I grew up and felt, that this is totally uninterrupted. It will not happen during my lifetime. Little did I know that this year it did happen. And as they say, أنا أريد وأنت تريد والله يفعل ما يريد. You may like something, you may wish for something, but Allah's will pass. And we've got to understand that in Islam we have a deen of action, a deen of life alternatives. And today in my short khutbah, I want to establish the beginning of a 3-week campaign. And I started in the first khutbah, and alhamdulillah, the response so far, I can't believe it. And I want to share it with you. I want first to establish an argument that is not mine. This argument was made for the last month and a half by muftis from reputable jurisprudence councils who advanced that during these difficult times, when Hajj and Umrah could potentially be suspended, now the decision was made, it is suspended. This year there will not be Hajj except for locals living there just to maintain the ritual. But no one from anywhere in the world will be admitted to do Hajj. What shall we do? Those jurisprudence councils suggested what is the best alternative based on the Quran and the Sunnah. And that is, those who are doing it for the second, third, fourth, whatever time, they have already done Farida, they've done the Hajj, which is required as an obligatory action once in a lifetime, they've done that. But they've been doing it often, and this year they were planning to do it, and they put money aside for that purpose. Or they wanted to do Umrah during Ramadan, they wanted to do Umrah after Hajj, they wanted to do Umrah, and they put money aside for that. Those jurisprudence councils said that it is best, they didn't say better, they said it is best for them to take this money and divert it in the direction of the millions of Muslims who are in desperate need, who are dying because of hunger, who are dying because of disease, who are, and I mentioned it last week, I mentioned Yemen. Yemen that broke all records, but there are conditions similar in Lebanon, in Syria, in Iraq, in Libya, in Rohingya, in many places where Muslims are in dire need. They want to eat. I know people who mentioned that they are wishing just for some bread that they can put in water. But it seems that when we are immersed in ni'amillah, in the favors of Allah, as we are in, people forget how human beings are living. And as the hadith related by Abdullah ibn Umar, reported by Bukhari and Muslim and many others, he said, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Listen to this. It's in the superlative. In grammar, it says, أَحَبْ, the best actions in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentioned four. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned four. سُرُورٌ تُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى مُسْلِمٍ أَوْ تَكْشِفُ بِهِ كُرْبَةً أَوْ تَقْضِي عَنْهُ دَيْنًا أَوْ تَطْرُدُ عَنْهُ جُوعًا. You may do four things that Allah would love to see you do. If you do something that will bring happiness to the heart of a Muslim, or you may do something that will relieve stress and depression and anxiety, condition, you go and do something to help in relieving that, Allah loves that. Or you will find someone who is in debt and could not pay back, and you pay that debt or part of it. And here, please, an aside, I received 3 weeks ago a dire request through a friend living in Vancouver about someone in Riyadh, in Saudi Arabia, who is under the category of Al-Gharimeen. He sent 6 children to school, and they are all geniuses. They excelled in their education. He borrowed money to send them to where they are today. One of them, by the way, is in Maryland doing his residency, and it was declared by the American Board of Medicine, the American Board, that never in their history someone wrote that board exam and got a full mark. It never happened. But that young man, the son of this man in debt, made it as a student who will enter history. But his father now is immersed in debt, and he was told, as the law is in the country, either you pay your debt or you will be jailed. This is the law. This person, zakatul mal, can be paid to this person. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you do that, Allah loves to see you do that. Or if you find people who are hungry, they cannot even eat once in 2 days or in 3 days. And what do they eat? They eat, as you know, that is story from his voluminous book, Ibn Kathir, in Al-Bidaya wal-Nihaya, the beginning and the end. He told the story of Abdullah ibn Mubarak once going for Hajj. He used to go every year. And once on the way, he came across a young girl who obviously looked extremely poor. And when he asked her about her condition, she said, يا سيدي ليس معي وأخي إلا هذا الإزار وليس لنا من القوت شيئا إلا ما bala, that we don't have anything except those pieces to cover us, pieces, it's not even a dress, and we don't have any food except that which we find from this garbage dump. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, who was going for Hajj, he said, I gave her everything I had for the journey and I returned home. And you know Abdullah ibn Mubarak, who was Abdullah ibn Mubarak? This is a real story. And we know that in Islam, niyyah comes before the actual physical amal. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Your niyyah is everything. If you had a niyyah to do something, but you could not do it, then in your book of record, it is written by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have done it. So if there were people whose niyyah was to go and do Hajj this year, but they were stopped of the COVID-19, so they got the ajr, they got the reward that they've done. They wanted to go for Umrah, they couldn't. They were waiting just to do Umrah, they couldn't. You know, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as a hadith reported by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, and we read it in Sahih al-Bukhari, إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدُ أَوْ سَافَرَ كُتِبَ لَهُ من العمل ما كان له صحيحا. Let me try to translate. If there were a servant of Allah who used to, while at home, while healthy, he used to have a certain wird, a certain perpetual deed, a certain thing he used to do all the time, but then he got ill or he embarked on a journey and he could not do it, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to put the ajr, even though he was unable to do it. Because his niyyah, her niyyah was there. So for those who wanted to go for Hajj this year and they couldn't, your niyyah got it for you. And also, a hadith reported by Anas ibn Malik and reported by Al-Bukhari. He said, we were accompanying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the campaign of Tabuk. We know Ghazwat al-Usra. It was the campaign that was filled with hardship and difficulty. And he said, that is Anas, on our way back, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during a recess, to rest in a shade or something, he addressed all of us and he said to us, Anas is saying, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, inna aqwaman fil madinati ma salakna sha'ban wala wadiyan illa kanu ma'ana habasahumul uzr. He said, there are people back in Medina, whenever we went between mountain ranges or in a valley or anywhere, they were with us, not physically, but in ajr. They were kept back in Medina because of valid excuses. And it is registered in the Quran, in Surah Al-Tawbah, that there were people who cried when they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, please take us with you, we want to go. He said, I don't have enough mounts for you to come with me, and you are old, you will not tolerate the heat of the desert all the way to Tabuk. It's about 800 kilometers from Medina. You will not. And they started to cry, and the Quran registered that. These people got the ajr because they had the niyyah. So what is required of us, and this is the campaign that I'm starting. Let's see what we can do. And I know that this khutbah is now live on Facebook, that there are people listening to it. And I will make this campaign as widespread as possible, but let us start in London. If you know anyone, if you yourself were planning to go for Hajj, if you wanted to go for Umrah, you can spare that money so that we can send it to those hungry people who don't know that we are talking بين يدي الله, that we are talking during this khutbah on this blessed day of Jumu'ah. Already I had four people after the first khutbah that we finished at 1:30. Four people already deposited money. And you know, I want to mention that if it were a Hajj and Nafila, that you've done Hajj already, and you want to deposit the entire cost of going for Hajj, you get the ajr. And the ajr of feeding those in need. And you know something, even $60 can feed an entire family for an entire month. Do it, and Allah will send barakah your way. Allah will protect your family. But if it is a Hajj al-Fariqa that you were planning to do, then the suggestion is whatever you could accumulate in a year, then you put that aside. You put that aside because Allah will help you to replenish that. As we read in Surah Sabah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه وهو خير الرازقين. Whatever you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will replenish it for you. It's not you. So it's a great cause. Great cause. The link is already live online. If you receive the newsletter, you will get it. Just go and click and you can deposit and save for Umrah and Hajj campaign. Please do it. Tell people about it. Let us see how we can, during the Barakah season of Hajj, how we can, as Muslims, help Muslims. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيفوز المستغفرين make دعاء الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولأستغفر ودعاء أمين يا رب العالمين. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Again, I repeat what I mentioned last week, brothers and sisters. We cannot afford to let our children feel that there's no masjid to that, you know. So they become isolated. They become separated. Don't do that to them and don't do that to yourselves. That's why, please, and I say please as your brother, don't isolate yourselves. This Sunday at 2:00, there will be the beginning of a new series called Messengers of God. I'll be talking about the 25 messengers and prophets mentioned in the Quran only. And I will be talking out of the Quran, no Israeliyat. Tune in at 2:00, it's on Zoom. If you receive the newsletter, then it is on the newsletter. Go and participate and listen and because this is a series. I cannot repeat the information again. Please do that, inshallah. And on Tuesday, let your children between the ages of 9 and 14 join in and have, as I called it, fun with Dr.Munir. I want to play with them virtually. I want to have nasheed. I want to have Quran with Dr. Ayman, and we'll have others to participate and give them some fun. And then on Thursday, have your young people between the ages of 15 and 20 express what's on their mind. Talk about current issues. We've got to connect. We've got to do the right thing. Please, if you don't receive the newsletter, on your way out, go back in, allow, you know, and I'll ask the brothers who are the ushers, allow them to go and register, or if the office is closed, give your email address to the brothers and they will pass it on so that you can receive the address. Let's stay connected. The other thing, if you are receiving the disposable prayer mat, then, you know, the cost is minimal. So just deposit $1, $5, $10 to help us buy the things, you know, the thermometers, the things that we need. You see those stickers that we have on the floor, you know, all these things. Don't let that be an extra cost for the center. Or just donate so that we can run this place as we are supposed to. Please do that. Let us stay connected. And I want to mention that the 12 o'clock Salat is 20 minutes, but for the 1:31, it may take a little bit more because I want to develop the idea. So today it took a little bit longer than what that 20 minutes that I mentioned to you. You can develop the idea. So the campaign, and don't just say, okay, I heard it, I'll do my share, and then, no! وَقُلِ عَمَلُوا فَسَيَرَى اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Do your share, and be connected. Tell your nephews, nieces, relatives, everybody to join in Sunday at 2, Tuesday at 3, and Thursday at 6. And tell everybody about the live khutbah, because many could not make it. They can at least still listen if they have an excuse. Because some people said, well, if we can make it and listen, we don't have to come here and bother. This is wrong. Please tell them. Save them from Allah's displeasure. Because some people say, well, you know what? I can hear it on the live and I don't have to come. No. The masajid are open. Look, there are still many places that are empty. And we had empty places at 12 o'clock as well. And there are people now who are sipping tea and drinking coffee. This is wrong. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, fil alamin innaka hamidun majid. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وخطايانا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا وكن علينا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله اكبر. الله يعلم ما تصنعون. واقم الصلاه.
الله اكبر الله اكبر. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله.